इंसान जितना सह सकता है उससे कहीं ज्यादा नफरत करते हैं हम तुमसे मस्तानी। तुम अपनी नफरत से हमारे मोहब्बत का इतिहास लिख रहे हो नाना। ऐसा क्यों उठा लो बच्चे को, ठहरो। जूठा का बेटा है अपने पैरों पर चल कर जाएगा। नाउ आई थिंक एवरीबडी हैज मेड मी दंडस बाजीराव मस्तानी एक्टिंग। मुझे लगता है कि नाउ इट्स टाइम फॉर भंसाली टू वॉच इट।
Anushka, welcome to India Today First. Yeah, first I want to ask you, what is the secret behind your Instagram handle, Reel, Anushka Reel?
I think because the minute Instagram introduced Reels, so I just put up a story that day. I was like कि अपना बना बनाया नाम छोड़ दूँ क्या, क्योंकि it was never for the Reels. The idea, or I can say a very kiddish idea behind that was that I am somebody who was very much away from social media because I started my journey from theater. And I was like, oh, this is not the real me. This is just the real me. So it's like, you're not able to find the real me over here. That was the case. But now I think the kind of content I've been putting up, I try to make it more of a, like a relatable content, which is like more of real me.
Amazing to really to hear, definitely.
Yeah, it was that. It was like that.
Also, can you, of course, everyone's talking about your film, Patna Shukla. Tell me, how did it all happen to you?
It started from a phone call from Mukesh sir. Actually, he called me and was like, hey, there's a film, and they really didn't want to tell me a lot about the film, honestly. I mean, they told me it's Arbaaz Khan film. I really wanted to know more about the character because I'm like, yeah, even if I'm coming for like even a scene, I really want to come prepared because I'm that kind of a person who love preparation, even if it's a small thing only, even life also. So I went there and he told me ki, just come, there's just one scene, you come, you'll kill it. I said, nahin, please. It's a different accent because I've never done a Bhojpuri accent. And
Yeah.
I really want to, take 15 minutes or let's say something, and then only I want to come. So I went there, and there I was expecting, like any other audition, there'll be a casting coordinator and taking the audition. But there was a panel of seven people sitting with my director, with my producer, and this was the first time, like seven people sitting in the room and taking my audition. I was like, okay, am I supposed to perform in front of everybody right now? I was like, theek hai. And I entered in my character only. I was carrying one prop, which was like a polythene. There was a bag, and Arbaaz said hi. I was like, namaste. And from there we started. I just performed just one take. Honestly, I wasn't happy because they all were applauding. I was like, theek hai, new blood. They are just trying to, boost my they're just giving,
Confidence,
trying
yeah.
to, yeah, just trying to give me that thing. And as like they might be doing it for everybody who's ever is coming. But yeah, it happened and they really liked it. And that's what
Amazing, amazing.
Arbaaz sir keeps mentioning even at the time of promotions also. It's like that one take, and we knew that we got ring.
It working with Raveena? Because someone, the 90s kids actually have grown up watching her, and to just share the screen space, that's a big
Absolutely
deal, frankly.
grown up watching her, grown up dancing on her show, on her songs for sure.
Awesome.
And for me, Raveena, when I went on set day one, so for me, we did very, very important scenes, two of the most important scenes, and that was
Yeah.
day one. Usually I try ki, you need 2 or 3 days to just to understand the,
Yeah.
how everybody's working, how everybody's gelling up on set. But there I really want to, strike a note because it's with Raveena. So I'm like, I have to perform well, and I want to perform well because then only we will be able to. That's how I wanted to break the ice with her. And that's what happened because Hum Nahin Jhukenge Didi was the first scene which we did, two of the most emotional scenes. And I got to know, like, she went to the monitor and she asked Arbaaz, who's this girl? So I think, like, the ice is broken. So then she made me sit and she told me a lot of things. I think she's the only actor who told me about the technicalities of camera when we were in the take. And I think this
Yeah.
only comes when you have so much with you are with so much of ease with your craft. Come on,
True.
30 years, man. 30 years.
Tell me, what has been the best compliment you received for Patna Shukla?
I'll be very honest. When we did a screening, Arbaaz sir did a screening, and it was a very intimate screening with only his family members. Saleem Sahu was there, Helen Shi, and everybody was there. And at that time, because there was no music, nothing was done. And it was very raw. It was a very raw cut. And I saw that and I was like, oh God, I have done so bad. And I think I thought, because if you look at the film, so though this, we have put the percentage, different sort of percentage, let's say if Raveena ma'am is talking in Bhojpuri accents, very less, because she's coming from a urban city. Mm-hmm. She's coming from Patna, and not everybody that talks like that. So, and I am coming from a gaon, just jahan pe meri primary schooling bhi hogi. So, wahan se mujhe aisa lag raha tha ki, yaar, I am the only one who's sounding so odd in everybody. But I think when I read the critics, I'm reading the reviews. So, the first thing which everybody was saying that was like the accent on point. I was like, thank God, because people know that I'm not from there and I have never done that before. So I think that's something, because I'm still, you know, thinking in my first language. And how you are in the moment and you're just bringing it out, I think it went well. So thank God, nobody, like, I wasn't caught.
Tell me, what has been your fan moment, like the first time you realized that you've become popular or people have been kind of appreciating your work?
So as I mentioned I started from theater, and then after that, if you talk about the screen work, so I started from the digital space where I was doing TVF, filter copy, stuff like that. And I'm somebody, if I am, you know, in my mood, I'll just, no makeup, nothing, I'm just wearing this dress only, I'll just go out and I'm like enjoying my time. So I was in Saket, and at that time I don't know why people were very scared of me, especially boys. I don't know why, honestly, maybe because my characters were so bold. I was like, "Maar dungi, ye kar dungi," and those kind of characters. So there were like a bunch of boys, they came to me and they're like, "Ki, Anushka, aapke saath selfie le," and literally their hands were shivering. "Aap maaroge tumhe?" I was like, "Main maarungi kyun?" So that was the first one. I was like, "Ki," and they were like, literally, I took their phone. I was like, "Let me take the selfie," because their hands were literally shivering. I was like, okay, good. So good, if boys are scared of me. So, yeah.
And how has your family taken up this newfound success and newfound popularity and fame that's come your way?
So, Sana, I come from a place where, you know, I come from a family of doctors and engineers, and it was told to me that actor ka doctor ka beta doctor banta hai, engineer ka engineer banta hai, aur actor ka beta actor banta hai. I was like, "Tum maternal aunt told me this." I was like, "Okay, theek hai, fir mere bacche ban jayenge actor." So that's true, but no idea how to do that. So I started from dancing. I did classical dancing. I have done senior diploma in Kathak, and then I was like, "Yeah, I'll go to some award functions and I'll ask somebody, excuse me, ye actor kaise bante hai, aur fir main actor ban jaungi." So that was my idea of, you know, cracking or getting my ticket to Bollywood. But my parents honestly faced a lot of things, because for me it was just taking a flight and coming to Bombay. For them, they were surrounded by these people where they were like, "Aapko pata hai kaisi kaisi scenes ladkiyan karti hain, aur bhai aur baap baith ke dekh bhi nahi sakte hain." And I went to one of my uncle's place, and my mom and I was sitting, and he was literally saying really, really bad things about the industry and how casting couch and everything works. And I very vividly remember how my mother, her face turned red, and she was like, "Meri beti aisa nahi karegi," and she was feeling bad also. I could, mere liye wo fark hi nahi pad raha tha, matlab wo sound off ho gaya tha, aur meri sight jo hai, sense of sight, wo work kar rahi thi, aur mujhe hearing sunai nahi de raha tha. And I could just see my mom, and she was feeling so embarrassed. And I still remember when today she received an award from the DM of Saharanpur, and she's like on Girl Child Day, and she's like, "Ki, I just didn't want to, you know, cut your wings." So I think kudos to that woman who was a part of that circle and was just trying to make way for her daughter. And I think I feel proud, because I think we as women somehow tends not to take a lot of credit. But today when I go back home, and I get to know from a lot of juniors of mine that they are like, "You have paved way for us. and we really want to come and we really want to pursue whatever we want to do in our lives.
Yeah.
So I think that's only what we live for. And I think once we are gone, that's only what we live, what we left, but what we leave for the other people, that's just the legacy. So yeah.
Amazing. But you rightly mentioned how people have this assumption that actor kabhi to actor banega, which is now a very big and important topic of discussion in the industry. Nepotism has become the buzzword. Anushka, when you look at your journey, or you know that you have that talent, but of course there are star kids on the way and you are competing with a lot of female star kids right now for that one role in a film. How do you deal with
when
that?
You and audition does for that something work? And then when you audition for something and you feel like ki, are ye to ho hi jayega, everybody is praising you in the audition as well, the casting team also, and then you feel like ki, oh, the poster got released and there's some star kid doing it. So yeah, that's happening.
Yeah, but does it feel bad, or have you kind of made peace with it that this is going to happen?
Sana, I say one thing. I chose this and I am a part of a game. Not game, literally, as in like, not putting it in a bad words, but when I say game, I chose this. And this is, let's say, I'm at a stage where I cannot change the rules of the game. I am somebody who's like, ki, acha, theek hai, I will take it. Because you can take a bet on you only when you can vouch on yourself, only when you have that much of self-confidence and when you are very much sure about your craft. Then only. If you feel like, yaar, if you start cribbing about, yaar, aisa kyun nahi hai, waisa kyun nahi, aap kar sakte ho. That's a choice. You can do that and you can indulge a lot of your time and a lot of your day in doing that. But I think I'm somebody's like, this is a part of my yes. game. I want to learn the rules of this game. I am in at it, and the minute I am at a stage where I can change the rules of the game, I will try to do that. And I think that's what all we can do that, because in corporate world also there are a lot of things which are not in your hand, be it appraisals and a lot of other things, but you can't do anything about that. All you can do is you can just work on your craft, and that's it. And we have to be thankful. I have to be thankful that I was born in a generation where craft is the bap of everybody. Nobody can do it for you. And I think there was a time in the industry when people used to live on the legacies of their parents, their grandparents. But now, today, you just cannot live on the legacy of your own, honestly. Because let's say a film got released which did amazing business and people praised you, but after 3 months they're like, where are you? Because there are so much projects being coming up and you have to just keep performing in every project and you have to give your best, because every week there are 30 projects coming up, there are 30 releases happening. So yeah, the competition. Absolutely. For sure.
Amazing. Lastly, Anushka, I cannot let you go without not asking you to mimic something. Your Daya Bandi is like, it always crops up on Instagram now and then. So please, three of your favorite mimics.
Three of my favorite mimics. I like, because I've put my tika on as like, hey, abhi, who's I telling that? Hey, ma, what the ji? के पापा को पता चलेगा कि हमने सना को ईद की बधाई नहीं दी तो अच्छा नहीं लगेगा, तो ईद मुबारक. So it is for Daya. Yeah, yes. That's Daya from Tarak Mehta.
Two more.
You are. My God. So this is a very beautiful scene from Bajirao Mastani, where somebody has come, like they have come, or Bajirao abhi bimar hai, aur Mastani ko jo hai unhone bediyon mein bandh rakha hai. और उनका बच्चा उनके पास है, और वो आते हैं कि नाना बोलते हैं कि इंसान जितना सह सकता है उससे कहीं ज्यादा नफरत करते हैं हम तुमसे मस्तानी, तुम अपनी नफरत से हमारे मोहब्बत का इतिहास लिख रहे हो नाना. आज लाइक क्यों उठा लो बच्चे को, ठहरो, योद्धा का बेटा है, अपने पैरों पर चलकर जाएगा. शमशेर बहादुर, हाँ अम्मी, खुद पर यकीन यानी जीत का पैगाम, डर यानी मौत का दूसरा नाम. कैसे योद्धा बनोगे तुम, पीछा बाजीरा बल्ला चाचा, खुदा हाफिज अम्मी, एंड आई लाइक व्हाट अ ब्यूटीफुल सीन फ्रॉम बाजीरा. You know,
Amazing.
there's
चलो
this mother who is like letting her child go because उसको सूली पे
आयो
चढ़ाने वाला.
स्कूल
What a scene, man. Now I think
या
everybody has made me done this Bajirao Mastani acting. अब मुझे लगता है कि now it's time for Bhansali to watch it. Please,
या
everybody has watched it now.